Natural history illustration is a wonderful art. It can really kind of very subtly highlight the features that are very important for a particular species in a way that a photograph can't necessarily.
Natural histories came about because we wanted to let people outside of the museum know about the rich rare book collection contained here. Scientific illustration serves many purposes. Obviously, in the days before photography and other forms of documentation developed, drawing or original art was the only way to capture the likeness of certain organisms, people, or places, and therefore was the only way to transmit or share this information with others. This is Hooke's Micrographia from 1667. This was the first time many people had seen any of these familiar objects through a microscope. Of the published works based on expeditions, none is better known than the zoology of the Voyage of the Beagle. Charles Darwin was a member of this trip and acted as the editor for the published work. While many of the illustrations are depicted on small, hand-colored lithographs, some illustrations, such as this reproduction of a toxodon skull, an extinct South American mammal, were deemed too important to show at a reduced scale and were produced in their natural size.
We don't know who created these beautiful, beautiful depictions of fish. But clearly, whoever it was, they were working extremely closely under the guidance of Marcus Bloch. This has probably been preserved for about 30 years. Even after, you know, a couple of months, this specimen has lost its color. So one of the great advantages of having a really good scientific illustration is that it can depict that color. And you can actually count the number of spines from the eye to the dorsal fin, and they would match these. And that's how we know that he was right. This is Diadon hystrix.
Maria Cibilimarian was the well-known 18th century illustrator who traveled to Dutch Suriname and collected and illustrated many of the insects she found there. In figuring out which works to include, we wanted examples that weren't incredibly widely known. We wanted to find some hidden gems within the collection. We also wanted to show a range of works and the printing processes contained therein. I hope this collection of images will give an understanding of the origins of the science behind these works and a better appreciation of the art illuminating their pages.